Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll discuss about Flipkart automation or Amazon automation, which is a retail based application where we are using these applications for purchasing a product. So we'll show you here how we can automate Amazon and Flipkart at the same time using UiPath. So if you want to learn UiPath or RPE based tools, so this is a best platform where you can learn it from scratch. So if you can see here we have created one flow for Amazon and another flow for Flipkart. We'll execute it and show the result. Post that, I will explain you how we can build this complete flow from scratch. Now if you can see here, execution has been started and this application is moved ahead to Amazon website where it is searching for an product. This product is available from online shopping and where based on the input from the user, this will get the detail for the user. Now here it is searching for the speaker with mic. Now text has been entered and this will navigate it to the options where it will fetch the name and the list and even with the rating wise. Exactly same thing, it will go to the Flipkart website and search for the speakers with mic. After searching this, this will fetch the detail and push it to the message box. So this is a complete flow where we are searching for a product from Amazon and Flipkart, both the site based on the user input. So now let's build this complete flow from scratch so that you will be able to understand. And by the way, if you think this will be useful, don't forget to press thumbs up button and hit bell icon so that whenever I will upload a new content, that will get notified to you. Now, first here, what I will do, I will close all this and create a new sequence. Within the new sequence, I will add open browser activity. Post adding the open browser activity, I will specify the URL which is an amazon.in where our browser search is navigate it to the Amazon and that will create a search option for me. So here in insert URL, I will just copy and paste amazon.in. Next options, I will add here type into. Within the type into, we will indicate on screen. So for the input point of view, we'll create here one arguments which is in product name and the type of argument is string. Exactly same way, we'll also create out for the product name. We'll change the directions for in and out. Based on that, we'll have this value is available. After that, we are saving this into out. Price. Next argument, we will create it for out. Rating. Here we'll specify the variable as in product name and then we'll proceed ahead with next actions to be added. Now this time we'll drag and drop click activity, and from click activity we'll indicate on screen to click on search icon. In the product name, we can add is the usual, or we can add the value as default value. So inside the default value, as of now, I'm adding Bluetooth speaker with mic. Now in next part, we'll add search for the product, and then here we will fetch the detail. For fetching the detail, what we can add here, like get text, so that we can extract the text detail. Here we have specified this specific text, and we are saving into out name. So adding in the value as a out name. Next activity, I will again drag and drop get text, and again we will capture the price. When we are capturing the price, we are saving into out price. Here for selector point of view, we'll specify the complete selector and validate it. Here we have specified the parent ID and search item, so that it will capture as we have highlighted the value. Now again we'll add one more get text activity to be capturing a reading. Here again we'll do the edit selector, and from the open in UI Explorer we will add it few of the details. So these details are specifically we are targeting to add parent class, so that we can add is leave condition as well, so that we will have the proper highlighted field which we are looking for. Now we have validated, and that's done for extracting the detail. And here again we'll specify the rating as a variable to store the rating. And after that, we'll create one more sequence. Within that sequence, we'll specify it for Flipkart. And the main sequence, we are adding it for the input dialog box, where we can ask with the user to enter the detail. So this will indicate with the input dialog box search the product. And then we can also give the label. Based on the label, we will see the detail. So enter the product name, and finally we'll store this input into product name, in product name. We'll specify here the value enter. And after that, we'll invoke the code Amazon sequence.xaml and showcase this value here. Just we have to import the arguments, and based on that, we are done. And next, what we will add as a new sequence for Flipkart sequence and exactly perform upper details. So first is like open browser, where we'll specify the URL or link detail of flipkart.com. Again, we'll use same arguments in flipkart.com as well and provide the default value. Next item we'll add type into. In type into, we'll specify the Flipkart detail, and again a next argument as out product name. So we have to make sure that we can use same argument in both the places, and direction or argument type also should be same, otherwise will feel challenges or will not get a proper output. After the product name is entered, we have to drag and drop click activity so that we can click for searching the product. And once the product is searched, we have to navigate it to next item, which is appear. So we need get text activity. So here we'll use table extractions to be stored. So extracted data which contains the name, which is a product name. Then the second item will be price and third is rating. Now we'll use assign activity to assign the output name value to be stored so that we can pop up this value on message box. So here we have to convert because this is a table value which we have used for extract data table.rows and we have to specify the row detail. So as of now, we are using to assign activity and third one is for rating. So name, price and rating, we have to use it. Next, we will invoke the Flipkart code into a new activity that is invoke workflow. Within that, we'll import arguments and once the argument will be imported, we are good to go. Here, we'll specify the value. For doing this, in the main activity, we will invoke the final workflow which we have created in main. So first it will execute for Amazon, then we are adding some delay for to be taken in between Amazon and Flipkart, and finally we will add this output value into message box. So message box will showcase the final output with us. Even we can use it the Excel file for storing this detail, but it's totally depending on us how we are proceeding. So that's done. We have to just save this and run the code and we'll get exactly what we are looking for. So let's sum up. We have started with creation of the flow for Amazon where our bot will go to the Amazon website, search for the product, extract the detail and store into one variable. After that, we have did it same thing for the Flipkart where after adding this, we have added those both the workflow into main activity. And from there, we have to pop up the value on message box. So that's it for this content. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.